Okay, last, so this week we will learn about predicate calculus. Okay, predicate calculus. Ada problem pula. Okay, predicate calculus. Right, this is the introduction of predicate calculus. So if you want to write it, Linda is a girl. So you like girl like this, Linda. So this must be function, okay, generalized function. Okay, this must be a general function and this can be a noun ataupun kata nama khas. Okay, a noun ataupun kata apa benda yang ni lah, benda yang kita boleh operate kan. Okay, this one would describe a verb. Usually this would describe a verb. But sometimes it can also be a noun. Tapi benda ni selalunya general lah. Okay, general. So Linda is a girl, Siti is a girl and so on. Okay, there are also two argument, predicate with two argument. Maximum biasanya ada dua argument saja ataupun dua RT. So on is fathers of Linda. And then this one would be pronounced as some. So this can be read as some one like Linda. It could be also Abu like Linda or Siti like Linda. But if you do not know whoever who likes Linda, you can say that someone like Linda. Okay, this one means that everyone like Linda or all people like Linda. Okay, contohnya macam ni, all children like Linda. So, how to write all children? So, in order to write all children, we can first broke it something like this. So we have child, okay, x. So this we child x, and then all, okay, all child, okay, all child. Kita tulis macam ni, okay, all child. So like Linda, kita akan tulis macam ni, okay, like, okay, Linda x. So this x will be replaced as all, okay. Kita akan baca ni sebagai all. So this would equal as all children. Okay, kalau penuh dia akan panggil children. Kalau satu dia akan panggil child. So read as all children. Alright, kemudian kita akan ganti ke sini. So kita tak tahu apa dia. Kalau kita buat macam ni, kita nampak macam everything. Okay, everything or everyone like Linda. But we want it to be written as all children like Linda. So to write it like this, kita kena ambil all children macam ni, like Linda. So kita kena tukar kat sini jadi all children. So in order to write this all children, kita akan letak x. Okay, di mana vx ni kita akan ganti dengan child x. Okay, kemudian kita akan tulis macam ni lah, all children like Linda. So it become all children like Linda. Okay, it become all children like Linda. Okay, another example. Dalam ni kita tengok, okay, contoh dia macam ni lah, all children like Linda. Okay, oh ini dia tak konsisten. Sepatutnya macam ni lah. Yang ni dia tunjuk sebagai every children like Linda like every children. Okay, yang ni maksudnya Linda like every children or all children is liked by Linda. Alright, kemudian kita tengok satu lagi latihan. Alright, tompok is not a person. So tompok is a person, kita letak not kat sini. So dia akan jadi tompok is not a person. Halim sit opposite Linda. So kat atas ni tulis kan, Halim sit opposite Ting Linda. So if tompok is a dog and Abu own tompok, and ada kat sini Abu own tompok, then Abu is tompok master. So then kita ingat alik dulu logik dia akan ada then, dia akan represent dengan ni lah, if then. So ingat tak yang kita lukis an or graph. So an or graph means this is then. So Abu is master of tompok. Okay, Abu is master of tompok. So every boy love football. So every boy. So sini all. So ini maksudnya all. So it can be read as all. So kita, kalau kita baca kat sini saja maksudnya all. So sama dengan child tadi lah. So Okay, kita nak tulis macam all boy. So boy mean boy is Halim. Okay, Halim is a boy. Okay, Halim is a boy. Okay. Okay. Gunan. Okay, Zahari is a boy. Boy. So, kemudian kita boleh tulis sekali boy X, okay. Boy X maksudnya ini all. So, maksudnya all boys. Kita nak kata all boys ni like football. Macam mana? So, kita akan buat macam ni lah. Kita tahu likes ni, contoh ni macam ni. So, football. So, kalau kita buat macam ni, dia akan jadi everyone ataupun everybody. So, kita nak buat jadi macam all boys like football, kita kena buat macam ni. Boy. Okay, like football. So, cara dia ditulis macam ni lah. So, yang ni kan kita akan kata all boys. So, dia seolah-olah macam kita ganti X ni sebagai all boys. Okay, yang ni kita akan ganti dengan ni ni. Okay, dia seolah-olah macam ni all boys like football. So, dari konsep dia begitu. Okay. There is a winning competitor. So, winning competitor. Yang ni sebenarnya salah sebenarnya. Dia kalau N ni agak mengelirukan. Saya lebih suka kalau kita tulis begini. So, kalau kamu ada nota, kamu betulkan dengan pen atau pencil. Okay. A competitor. So, a competitor kita boleh tulis sebagai one ataupun sum. Okay, sum macam ni. So, competitor, X, right? Okay, X. Okay, X. Okay, some competitor ataupun a competitor. So, winning. Dia akan jadi winning, X. So, there is a winning competitor, maksudnya sum X competitor. Ini lebih betul lah. Okay, according to my experience, this one is much more consistent. Okay, dalam nota ni dia tak berapa betul sangat. Okay, so bila kita baca, ini dia maksudnya a competitor ataupun sum competitor. So, kalau maksudnya winning ni, winning X. Maksudnya kalau kita letak ni winning Abu. Maksudnya Abu is winning. Ataupun winning city. So, means that city is winning. So, kalau kita tulis macam ni, kita nampak macam someone is winning. Okay, some competitor. Sorry, bukan someone. Some competitor is winning. So, dia lebih kuranglah sama maksud dengan someone is winning, competitor in some competitor is winning, some competitor is winning. Lebih kurang ataupun inti boleh tukar jadi a competitor is winning. So, sebab dia ada sum ni dia boleh jadi a juga. Okay, certain ataupun certain. So, certain competitor is winning. So, bila kita baca kat sini dia jadi sum ataupun a. So, a competitor dia akan ganti sini a competitor is winning. So, ini lebih tepat daripada dalam buku tunjuk. Dalam buku ni tunjuk agak mengelirukan. Example 5, kamu ganti dengan apa yang saya tulis. Ada pen and pencil, just betulkan balik example 5 and 6. Okay. 6 pun sama. Okay. Contoh macam kalau kita nak buat basic, stole money. Ali money. So kita faham bahawa Ali stole money. Right. Okay. Ataupun kita kata Abu money. Okay, ni cara kamu fikir stole money. So boleh kata X ataupun like some all people. Okay, stole ni. Katakan kalau kita replace ni dengan X. So, okay. Kemudian dia kata some person. So, person. Person Ali. So Ali is a person. Person Abu. Okay. Abu is a person. So kita nak construct satu ayat dia. X. X is a person. So untuk macam ni kita ganti macam all. Everybody is a person. Kita tukarnya jadi P macam ni. So macam kita belajar itu last week. Ini somebody. Dia akan jadi some. Okay, somebody. Kalau macam A ataupun B terbalik tu, kita akan panggil dia sebagai all. Right? Kita akan panggil dia sebagai all. But this one kita panggil some. So this one become everybody is a person. Somebody is a person. So untuk construct ayat, some person stole the money. So some X person X stole money. So which kita boleh katakan kat sini somebody. Okay, somebody stole money. Okay, somebody kita ganti dengan sini lah. Okay, ataupun some person. Okay, sebab dia tu boleh some person. So dia akan jadi some person lah kat sini. Some person. Kita baca some person. Right? Some person. Okay. Some person. So dia akan jadi macam ni. So example 6 pun kena tukar macam saya tulis tadi. Right? Ni pun sama. There is number between 1 and 20. So some number between 1 and 20. Right, yang ni kita tak, saya tak mau revisit. Okay, kita revisit, kita tengok yang ni. All member either can sing and dance. Right, so all member can sing or dance. So sing, act and dance, act. So bila kita kata sing, kita kata Ali can sing and dance. Kita boleh tulis sini sing, Ali and dance. Okay, Ali. So Ali is singing, Ali is dancing. So we can say that Ali is singing and Ali is dancing. Okay, dance. So bila kita kata all, all member, so we can say that this thing is a variable, dance. So, all member, kita tahu dah benda ni universal all, okay. Pronounced as every or all, okay. So, kita kata benda ni sebagai member, X. So, dia kan jadi all members. So, bila kita ganti ya, X member. So, everything yang ada X kat sini. So everything that have X kat sini akan jadi all. So all member can sing. Okay, all member can sing and dance. Okay, dance. Right, all member can sing and dance. So this can be pronounced as all members. So ini X ni sebenarnya boleh ganti dengan all members lah. Bila kita buat macam ni X. Sebab dua-dua X. Benda ni X. All members. Nanti kita tengok yang ada X dengan Y pula. Kalau ada X dengan Y lain pula. Okay, all members. So konsep dia macam ni sahaja. Okay, this one somebody is loved by everybody. So inilah yang ada konsep is that have that have X and Y. Okay, everybody love someone. Right, everybody love someone. Okay, yang ni dalam ni solution dia agak what can I say is agak mengelirukan sikit lah. Ha, kaedah ni agak mengelirukan sikit. Okay, So, bila kaedah ni agak mengelirukan, kita, saya rasa saya akan skip ni lah sebab dia agak mengelirukan sikit. Tapi yang ni boleh lah. Yang ni boleh terima, yang EX ni, yang EX. Yang EX 10 ni kita boleh terima, example 10. Okay, someone is loved by everyone. Okay. Ni contoh dia lah, contoh dia. Okay, yang ni kita boleh kata everybody love Linda. Ha, senang kita kata everybody love Linda. Ataupun Linda love everybody. Okay, Linda love everybody. So this one, Linda love everybody. And then this one, kita boleh kata okay, everybody love Linda. But sometimes kita ada dua parameter. Bila ada dua parameter, dia boleh juga X dengan X. So, ataupun X dengan Y. Okay, kalau benda operand dia lain-lain, X dengan Y. So, means that everybody love everybody. Okay, ini maksud dia. Cuma kita perlu letak tambah VX, VY lah maksudnya. VX, VY. Untuk terangkan lagi sebab bila kita kata every, dia kena ada V ni, ha, atau VA terbalik, okay. So, ni baru terang, everybody loves everybody. Okay, nak terangkan lagi, dia kata ni everybody loves someone. So, perimeter kedua yang akan jadi someone. So, bila perimeter kedua akan jadi someone, kita tahu benda ni akan jadi beginilah. Everybody loves someone. One. So, mana yang nak jadikan jadi sum? Parameter kedua akan jadi sum. So, parameter pertama tetap jadi everybody. Parameter kedua akan jadi sum. So, kita jadi macam ni lah. Everybody love someone. Love X dengan Y. Okay. Everybody love someone. So, this will become everybody. This will become sum. Sebab ada logo sum. So, everybody love someone. So, example 10, macam tu solution dia. So, Disney unification, okay. Sampai takat ni, kita boleh buat latihan sedikit. So, hari tu saya cakap macam mana kita buat latihan. Suruh buat latihan sedikit. So, kita akan lihat balik prepositional logic. Latihan ni macam mana. Okay, saya cover sikit, batin leleng, kamu boleh tahu sendiri. So, this one yang last week punya. So, if logic is easy, then I pass the exam. So, if logic is easy, the assign per P, I pass the exam, R. Alright? Okay, this is A. So, for B, if I pass the exam, then logic is easy. So, R imply P. Okay, for C, I feel the exam if logic is difficult. So if dia ada kat belakang, tapi if bila kita tulis logic, if dia kena ada dekat depan. So if logic is difficult, so not P, imply not R. Okay, imply not R. Okay. If there is no logic question, then I pass this the exam. So not Q, then I pass the exam means R. Okay, R. Okay, begitu sahaja. Okay, kalau kita nak buat. Okay, this one is recorded. Nanti saya upload. Alright, kemudian kita tengok pada E. Logic is difficult. I pass the exam if there is no logic question. So, logic is difficult. So, logic is difficult means not Q. Okay, not Q. Kemudian bawah not Q, ini ada satu ayat, dot. Okay. Satu ayat. Dia ada dot. Okay, then dot kedua. I pass the exam if there is no logic question, not Q. Imply R. So, dia ada dua-dua. Dia ada dua-dua macam ni. Bukan dua jawapan. Ni satu jawapan tapi this one satu ayat. Yang ni satu ayat yang lain. Okay. So, either logic is easy and I pass the exam or logic is difficult and I fail. So, either logic is easy and I pass the exam or logic is hard and I fail. So dia ada and dengan or. So kita tengok benda ni. Yang ni Aizer. Aizer ni dia duduk di Aizer ni ada kaitan dengan sini. Oh, okey. Oh. Okey, N ni sebenarnya bukan betul-betul N. N ni sebenarnya imply. Okey, imply dia kata N. So untuk menerangkan lagi, saya copy paste ayat sini. Dia sebenarnya kita kena buat macam boolean algebra sikit. So untuk jawab soalan ni. So either or kan, kita belajar English either or neither no. Okay. So ini dalam kes ni kita ada either or. Okay, in the English we have either or. So either or maksudnya kita akan fokus dekat sini sebab or dia berlainan. So ni, sini yang or. So kita tahu ayat dia adalah something one or something number two. Okay. So ayat dia macam ni lah, either or. Either or. So kita nak figure out apa dia one ni. Okay, one or two. Okay, one or two. Either dia. So one. So kita akan check penyataan one. Penyataan one dia, logic is easy and I pass the exam. So logic easy and I pass the exam bukan P and Q sebenarnya. Bukan P and Q. Dia sebenarnya if. Sebenarnya if logic easy then I pass the exam. So dia lebih pada P, sorry P and R tak silap. Okay, ini P and R. R pass the exam. P. Okay, P and R. Okay, P. Dia sebenarnya P. If P imply Q. And then yang number two, penyataan number two would be equals logic is hard and I fail. So not P imply not R. So kita ganti kali one and two. Ayat dia akan jadi P imply R or okay, not P and not R. N. Sorry. O. Dia tulis dekat sini O. So O. So dia kan jadi macam ni lah. So dia masih juga begini jawapan dia. So ada sengah dia kreatif. Bila dia kreatif dia boleh buat macam-macam lagi lah. Tapi bagi saya ini jawapan betul lah. Ada sengah dia kreatif dia buat macam ni. Dia buat not P. So N not R. Okay, or dia akan jadi not. Okay, not P. Kemudian dia akan jadi N. Sebenarnya dia akan jadi R. Okay, right. Right, okay, dia bukan buat macam ni. Sebab dia pakai teorem. Dia punya equivalent. So ini pun betul juga. Okay. Ini pun betul juga. So depend on how you would try to write it. Yang ni sebab dia buat equivalent. Yang kedua ni dia boleh dapat dengan equivalent. Kalau dia nak guna and juga. Nak dia guna and dia akan jadi macam ni lah. Kita tukar ni jadi or. Ini kita not kan. Kemudian kita keluarkan not. Duduk kat luar. So saya akan jadi begini lah. Alright. So if logic is easy then there is a logic question then I pass the exam. So then dia ada dua kali. So macam mana nak buat? So this one kita panggil nested. Okay, nested if ataupun macam kita buat dalam programming banyak kita pakai nested if. So nested if. So how to do nested if? So kita akan tengok kat mana then dia ni kat mana. So ini maksud dia kat luar ni dia ada satu big if lah. Big if dia kan dekat luar. So big if dia kat luar kat sini sebenarnya big if dia. Ha. Right. So maksudnya if one then then two. Okay. So two kita tahu siap-siap dah. Two is sama dengan I pass the exam. Sama dengan R. So kita nak figure out one. So one ni adalah if logic is easy. So P imply Alright, so P imply if there is no logic question. So contoh dia, if there is no logic question, dia ada satu lagi implication dia. So if logic is, then if there is no logic question, I will pass the exam. So there is a logic question. Logic question Q imply. So jawapan dia macam ni lah. Right? Okay. Bila kita translate balik, okay, so bila kita translate balik, bila kita buka balik kurungan ni, so dia memadai. Okay, you can use method ke ni. If there is, if logic is easy, then there is a logic question, then I pass the exam. So dia imply dua kali macam ni. So this is G. And then next, there is a hash. So there is a hash. Right, ini pun sama. If logic is difficult, then I pass the exam if there is no logic question. Cuma yang ni, if dia duduk di belakang. Okay, if dia duduk di belakang. Trick question, but you can do it if you have enough training. So kalau kita train selalu, kita boleh nampak dia punya perbezaan dia. Kadang-kadang benda ni masuk dalam final exam. So, what happens is that you can rearrange this one. Okay, if. Okay. Okay, if. Then. Okay. So, kita nampak ni kalau kita rearrange balik. Alright. So, kita mark down kat mana dia ada then. So, if logic is difficult, not P. Okay, imply. There is no logic question, mean not Q. Then, I pass the exam R. So jawapan ni macam ni lah. Kita susun balik je if ni duduk kat depan. So nampak mudah lagi. Okay, if there is no logic question, not P. Sorry, not not Q. No logic question, then I pass the exam. Kemudian if logic difficult, then kita ada ni. If logic is difficult, then baru dia masuk ke dalam ni. So this is also supposed to be relatively easy. So ini kamu cuba buat, saya nak buat sesuatu yang lain. Ini semua kamu boleh check jawapan ni sendiri. Kita nak bincang berkenaan yang predicate calculus tadi. Otherwise you can ask me final examination question. Kalau kamu buat latihan, kamu boleh tanya dalam WhatsApp ke apa-apa. Oops. Yeah. Tutup. Sekejap. So continue back in practice make perfect. Okay, this one kita boleh buat preposition. Right, ikhlas. Okay, yang ni NO diagram. This one, kalau orang tanya nanti kamu boleh tanya kemudian. Okay, resolution and repetition kita akan cover nanti. Alright. Okay, kita cuba buat ni nanti kemudian. Saya bagi satu contoh. Translate the following predicate into English sentences. So, how to do this? Ini penting juga kadang-kadang soalan dia minta tanya ataupun secara tak langsung kita kena faham apa maksud perkataan di sini. Alright. Okay, this means that okay, every father to a father. Okay, every father to a father is a male and parent to another father. Okay. So, ayat dia macam tu lah. So, every father to a father is a male and parent to another father. right? This one, X is all. So all father is a grand all father to someone is also a father to is someone grandfather, right? All father to some one is a grandfather to to every father. Okay. Okay. All son is a male. Okay. All son to some all son to every parent is a male. Okay. Okay, this one is a brother is a male sibling. Okay. Okay. Oh, sorry, sorry. All brothers is all is a male sibling too. Is everybody's male sibling, sorry. Okay, all brothers is everybody's male sibling. Terengkahkan, jadi macam ni. Alright, this one. Okay, this one. Last week saya tunjuk sikit. A, put apple. A chicken is food. Or, kalau kita nak follow yang jenis atas, kita kata food is, chicken is a food. Okay. Do you like ice cream? So, how to write like that? So, okay, kita akan tulis cream. Bill. All bill. Okay. E, kita kena follow format yang general. Okay, studies. Okay, A12. Sorry, A12. Bill. F. Actress. Okay. Distance. I semua huruf kecil because it is a constant, not a variable. Okay, love spinach. Okay. Okay, kita boleh tulis macam ni juga. Papai loves spinach. Never eat. Kita boleh buat not macam ni, simbol dia, ataupun not macam ni. Okay, not. Okay, boy, eggs. Okay, Bill takes Edom piece. The umbrella is red in color. So, kita akan tengok apa yang lebih general. So the most general one is umbrella is red in color. Okay, sorry, saya pakai ABC pula. This one is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay, and 10. 11. Stalin was a dictator and not an ancient Greek. So, dictator ni lebih general. So, kita buh dictator. And not ancient Greece. This is also a dictator. Right, studies sama juga. Okay, Bill, kalau letak macam ni pun boleh juga. Sebenarnya, tapi kena konsisten. Kalau kalau kita follow ni, kita boleh buat lah. Boleh juga buat, tapi kena konsisten. Okay, consistency is the key. Alright, ada soalan tanya. Bill eat peanut and still alive. And still alive. So, Bill eat peanut. Kita tengok kalau kita nak letak eat. Kita letak ni bagi konsisten dengan nombor 8. Okay, konsisten dengan nombor 8, Bill eat. Alright, sekejap, saya pause sekejap, ada hal sedikit, kamu cek tengok. Alright, okay. Boleh sambung balik. So, Bill eat peanut and. So, kita kan ada and still alive. Alive. Bill. So, right, okay, 13, Rudolph is a reindeer, okay? Rudolph is a reindeer, Rudolph has a red nose. So, rain, marine, hijau sini, reindeer, Rudolph, and, okay, bukan and, dia ada comma, so has a red nose. So, dia kena buat ajak ayat lain lah, okay, as a red nose. So red nose to dog. Okay. Jadi kalau dia tak ada N, dia tak ada O, kita kena buat ayat lain lah. Every child loves Santa. So kita buat macam ni. This night every children. Buku ni salah sikit dia punya ayat English dia. So every child, ingat every child macam ni. Loves Santa. So kita tahu somebody can love Santa. So macam ni Santa. So dia akan ganti every child love Santa. Right? Okay. So dia akan jadi every child love Santa lah macam ni. Every child love Santa. Okay, every child love Santa. Every man like tasty apple. Alright, tasty apple. So, this one maksudnya macam ni X, right? Tasty apple. So, maksudnya bila kita buat macam ni, Ali like tasty apple. Betul tak? Okay. B like tasty apple. So, ini kita kata macam every one. Tapi dia kata man. So, man. Man kita kena buat macam ni, man. Okay. So, contoh macam Ali is a man. Okay. Right? Bill is a man. So, man. So, every man, contoh macam ni, every man, right? Tasty apple. So, ganti kat sini, kan? Dia jadi macam sama enggak format dia. Every man. Okay. So, ini kita sampai satu part bila kita kata kadang-kadang kita boleh buat, kadang-kadang kita tak boleh buat. So, tapi kamu kena strong bahagian ni lah. Nanti saya akan cuba buat interaktif, okay, latihan interaktif supaya kamu boleh supaya kamu boleh buat lah benda ni, supaya kamu boleh faham. Sebab nak survive chapter seterusnya, sini kena mahir baru kita boleh survive chapter seterusnya. So eat, okay, ingat balik soalan nombor 8 tadi, eat kan, macam ni eat, okay, eat. Dave eat boy egg. Dave do not eat boy egg. So eat maksudnya X. And X ni maksudnya animal lah kan. Animal. Sepatutnya kan animal eat custard. Okay. Animal eat custard. Tapi dia kata every animal. So kita kena ganti ni X. Animal. X. So every maksudnya X lah macam ni. So kita gantilah jadi macam ni. So ini sebenarnya every animal. Dia nampak macam awal-awal nampak macam impossible, tapi kalau kamu pecahkan dia jadi per unit, dia nanti dapat jadi mudah. Oh, human are mortal. So mortal ni maksudnya boleh mati lah. Mortal. Okay. So Ali is mortal. Okay. Okay. Security guard is mortal. A guard is mortal. Huh? Police. Policeman is mortal. So mortal. So every human. So human. Ali. So Ali is a human. Abu is a human. So everybody is a human. All human. So all human. Kita ganti macam ni lah. All human. Ipin. All Welsh is people are British. So British. So ini mudah. Kita ganti dia. All Welsh are British. Okay. Semua orang Welsh adalah orang British. All rich people pay taxes. To pay tax. Okay, saya pay tax. Okay, saya pay tax. So, I pay tax. So, Abu pay taxes. Okay. Okay. Vincent, okay. Pay taxes. Right? So, all rich people. So, all rich. Okay, rich people. So, it's really rich people lah. Okay, rich people. Okay, so all rich people pay taxes. Kadang-kadang dia tulis rich saja sebab kita tahu kata Ali. Ali is rich, Abu is rich. So, kita tak rich. So, all rich people, dia akan jadi macam ni lah. Everybody who are rich pay taxes. Sebab benda ni jadi macam ni. Everybody. Okay, everybody who are rich pay taxes. So everybody loves somebody. So okay, kalau kamu rasa susah, okay, macam tadi everybody, dia tunjuk dah person, okay, why love somebody, okay, okay, why, okay. John like all kind of food. Okay, John like all kind of food. Okay, ada setengah orang kata ini susah nak buat. So, sebenarnya mudah, kamu kena lihat balik apa predicate like. Okay. John like Linda. Alright. Okay. John like Siti. John like everything. Okay. John like all kind of food. Okay. Macam ni kan. Maksudnya John like Linda kalau kita baca ni. John like Abu. Betul tak? John like Siti. So, all kind of food. Okay, kita kata macam ni. So, apa ganti kepada all kind of food? Maksudnya, food X, betul tak? Okay, food X. So, kita ringkaskan jadi like X. John like everything. So, food X ni adalah sejenis food lah. Food. So, all food. Okay. Mudah saja. So, dia akan jadi macam ni. All food. Okay, John like all food. Okay. Right, ada setengah orang kata, oh lama ini susah nak buat apa semua. It's not that tough, okay. Right, Sue eat everything, Bill eat. Okay, apa Bill makan, Sue makan. Apa Bill makan, Sue makan. Okay, yang ini kita kena pecahkan juga. Eat. Okay. Okay. Bill makan kacang, okay, peanut. Right, so maksudnya bila Bill makan kacang, Sue pun makan kacang. Okay, Sue pun makan kacang. So, eat Sue peanut. Okay, kita faham macam tu lah. Betul tak? Okay, kalau okay, so kalau Bill makan kacang, maka Sue pun makan kacang. Alright, kita nampak satu perhubungan kat situ. Alright, okay. Take. Okay, Bill eat cake, maka Sue pun makan cake. Makan cake. So, Sue eat everything that Bill eat. So, apa? Kalau Bill makan, okay. Bill makan ayam. So, kita tulis ayam. Okay, Bill eat ayam, Sue pun eat ayam. So, ayat dia begitulah. Okay, Sue eat everything that Bill eat. Okay, Bill makan ayam, maka Sue pun makan ayam. So, Bill eat X. Kita tak ada benda ni X. Sue pun eat X. So benda ni maksudnya dia akan jadi macam ni lah. Okay. Okay. Alright. Okay. Yes. Dia jadi macam ni. Zen. Okay. Benda ni akan jadi zen. Tapi dia tak lengkap lagi. Dia kena ada food. Okay. So every food. So benda ni akan jadi macam ni lah. So kurungan. Kurungan. So macam logik tadi. So dia akan jadi macam ni. Bill it. Food, Su pun eat every food. Bill eat every food, Su pun eat every food. Okay, maksudnya if Bill eat apple, okay, Bill eat apple, Bill eat apple, maka Su pun eat apple. So kita boleh test macam tu. So okay, not that hard. Kalau apa-apa kamu boleh rewind balik dalam dalam video. Alright, anything anyone eat and isn't killed by is food. So kita tengok anything anyone eat and isn't killed by. Anything anyone, anything anyone. Maksudnya apa-apa benda yang orang makan dan tidak boleh di dan tidak boleh dibunuh oleh anything tersebut. Alright, kita ada tiga kata kerja. Eat, killed by, right. Okay. Eat, kill by food. Eat, kill food. Eat, kill food. Okay. Eat, kill food. Okay. Kita ingat lagi. Eat ada dua. X, Y. Okay. Bill, eat, chicken. Betul tak? Okay. Kita ganti. So, kill by pun ada dua. Seorang bunuh seorang lagi. Bill, kill by chicken. Kita ganti pula. Okay. So, food ni yang mana satu? Bill ke chicken yang food? Alright? Okay? Ni fikir logik. Food ni Bill ke chicken? Right? Mestilah. Okay, mestilah chicken. Okay, chicken adalah food. Alright? Okay. Bila chicken food, kita anggap bahawa X sama dengan Bill, Y sama dengan chicken. So, bila kita ganti balik, eat X, Y, okay, and not kan, not killed by kan, not killed by X, Y, gerinti tak silap dah ni. Lepas tu chicken tadi kita ganti dengan Y. So kalau kamu buat ni gerinti tak silap. So everything, maksudnya everything, every one, okay, every one, okay, X. Satu X, satu Y. So ini penyataan lengkap dia. Alright. Okay, ini jawapan dia. So bila baca everything that eat okay, everyone that eat something and isn't killed by something, then that something is food. Okay, that something is food. Bila kita baca balik ayat dia memang macam tunggang terbalik, tapi penyataan ni sama. Okay, anything that that everybody can eat and isn't killed by that anything, then that thing is a food. Okay, that thing is a food. Okay, isn't killed by is food. Okay, that thing is food. Bila kita ganti balik X, Y dengan chicken, X dengan Bill, dia akan jadi macam ni lah. Bill eat chicken, Bill isn't killed by chicken, then chicken is a food. Okay, 24. Every apple is either green or yellow. So apple, every. So, every apple. So, kita akan dapat every apple. Okay. Color green or okay, yellow. Okay. Right. You can write up like this. Or, dia ada dua, satu lagi kat Ada. Depend on the situation. You can write it something like this. Like this. Green or yellow. Okay. Okay, this one dia anggap kata benda ni duduk di hujung spektrum. Okay, di hujung spektrum. It depend. Nanti dia akan satu dua situasi lah. Either kamu pakai option one ataupun option two. Tapi ini depend pada situation. Situation nanti dalam final exam saya akan tunjuk lah kat mana buat. Okay, no person like a smart vegetarian. So ini dia ada imply. No person, maksudnya every person lah. No person means every person. Okay. Tapi every person negate. Okay, maksudnya maksudnya benda ni nobody lah. Ha, nobody. Tak ada siapa. So no person mean person X. Not. Okay. Imply like a smart vegetarian. Okay. So X smart veggie. Okay. Mudah saja. Okay, maksudnya kalau kita buang ni, kita kata every person like smart vegetarian. Bila kita letak not, okay, nobody, no person like smart vegetarian. So, very simple. Alright, I just want to stop at here. Kamu cuba buat latihan, sambung. Lepas tu nanti, nanti kita cuba discuss lagi lah next week. Kita jumpa discuss lagi. Memang slow sikit. Kalau kamu nak tanya soalan, kamu ambil peluang ni next week. Nanti next week kamu upload lah. Kamu upload sambil kita discuss. Okay, saya akan buka ruang upload dalam kelas work. Kamu cuba buat sampai habis lah nombor 43. Okay, yang ni kita tak bincang lagi. Kita ambil sampai nombor 43. Sebab next week saya nak ajar kamu ini resolution reputation. Untuk resolution reputation kamu kena cakap lah buat benda ni. Kamu kena cakap buat benda ni. Alright, nanti tak apa benda ni saya record, kamu boleh replay balik. No problem. Alright, it's already 45 minutes. So saya rasa saya stop, takut kamu overload. So cuba buat ini. So kalau dalam kelas betul pun biasanya kelas saya akan run about 1 hour. In face-to-face class. Dalam classroom physical pun selalunya benda ni saya akan run about 1 hour. Nanti saya akan selang dengan latihan. Kemudian kita akan bincang balik lah. So same goes here. So nanti kita jumpa balik next week. Kamu cuba sambung sampai nombor 43. Alright. Okay. Alright, that's all. Nanti kita jumpa balik. Jangan lupa isi kehadiran. So kehadiran isi dalam hadir.work. Okay, kamu fill in the questionnaire. Dalam tu ada questionnaire untuk kamu punya data. Kamu pakai telco mana, kemudian kamu punya kuota. Okay, kuota. Data kamu banyak mana, seminggu ke, sebulan ke, 10 gig sebulan, dan rating lah. Kamu rasa puas hati ke tak dengan telco kamu tu. Dengan connection lah untuk kelas online ni. So, that's all. Kita akan jumpa kemudian lah. Okay, video saya upload. Okay, nanti kamu boleh tengok balik. So, kita jumpa lagi. Assalamualaikum. Continue back next week.